decentralized BitTorrent, so there is no tracker. Or another way to say that is your machine is part of the tracking. Freenet was really popular about 10 years ago, and it sort of has a really core community that's used for large file sharing, lots of copyright. GigaTribes is, as far as I can tell, used for child abuse. I'm sure it has legitimate uses, it's a real company, but I've never seen anyone use it besides for illegal file sharing. RetroShare is one of the original ones. It's basically a PGP-based darknet that lets you set up friend-of-a-friend networks, and then if you start trusting random people, you can sign their PGP key, share PGP keys, and join their file-sharing networks. Having joined some of these, you get the most random infected malware you could ever imagine. I've gotten copies of Microsoft Office, copies of PDFs that claim to be here's secrets of the U.S., hoarding alien technology. Every single one of them is infected. The best PDF I got was a simple copy of the original Tor paper that describes what Tor is. Inside it had 20,000 separate files. It basically was an entire virtual system inside the PDF running as a virtual machine. When you open it up in actual Adobe Reader, it then installs a Bitcoin miner, ransomware, and remote access Trojan. So you get three malware in one for one PDF. Most impressively, this whole PDF is only like 10 megabytes large. So someone spent a lot of time figuring out how to pack an entire operating system and three malware into one PDF for you. OneSwarm and GNUnet are both...